And it was my keyboard player, Gavi. And he'd been with me since my very first ever show that I ever did. And, you know, we toured the world together and had adventures and he'd really become a brother to me and he'd become my best friend. And before he got sick, though, we started writing a song together. And every time I would visit him in the hospital, I'd tell him, hey, before you know it, we're going to be on tour again, we're going to be seeing the world, and we're going to finish that song that you started. And it never ever crossed my mind that he might not get better. Just, it wasn't even a possibility. And so after he passed away, I've learned a lot, I guess I should say, in the last year. I've always believed my entire life that there is life after this, and that we go somewhere after we die, that there's a plan for every single one of us. I've always believed that. But through this year, I've gained such a strong belief that the other side is a lot closer than I ever thought it was, because I felt so much love and support from God, kind of picking me up and carrying me through these times that I didn't feel like I was strong enough to face. And also, I know that Gavi is still with me, with all of us, in so many ways. I've had so many little signs just kind of show up in my life that are not coincidences that show me that he's definitely my guardian angel now. One of which, I'll just tell you one of these little stories. He was a huge 49ers fan, diehard 49ers fan. He was always telling me, Lindsey, you have to play the national anthem at a 49ers game so I can go and get included seats. And sure enough, a couple months ago, I, out of nowhere, got a call to play the national anthem at the 49ers football game. That he's my guardian angel. You know, I didn't say he wasn't slightly selfish.